the last question, I think you answered it in a way, but how do you actually raise a child who is a contributing member of society?
What are you talking about when you are across the table, say a dining table? What are your conversations on? Because is your conversations on very superfluous things like a TV show or what's happening or a game or whatever it is? But is it on deeper stuff? Is it about what is happening in the world around us? What is the place that we have to make this place a better place? It all goes back to the parents' characteristics. What is their belief system? What is their value system? So that a child will again look at, will emulate, will talk about, maybe mull in their minds about. And then that becomes an impression on the child. And then they in turn become contributors.
Yeah, I think it goes to the fundamental question of what actually is one's life's purpose. So these were actually questions that were reverberating in my mind even when I grew up. Where I am really asking that to myself as to what this life's purpose is. Obviously it's in a way observable in the fashion in which it is actually being maintained as you see people around. And yet there is a missing element if it were only about survival. So the question that is was an important question to me, I'm imagining for every soul or a person born in this world. It's a question, a deep question. And these are all obviously questions that man has been seeking answers for. So to be able to portray to the growing child that life is not about existence, it is about you being a player, making contribution. That teaching starts right from the beginning. You know, when you sit at your table, when you get up from your table, when you lie down, when you get up, when you go out, when you come in. What's the messaging? That's very important in the formation of a child. Because there are all kinds of messaging that goes on. There's a lot of emptiness that is around. There's a lot of aping that goes around, where people don't even think. The powers of mind is never used often. You just ape. You just want to be a clone. But that's not a human design. Because everyone has got an individuality and everyone has got a distinct purpose. Everybody has got pre-given talents. So the journey of life in itself is not about primarily survival. Though survival is needed, but it's not something that you very, you know, sheepishly accept as the dominant thing about life. And so when the messaging is, in spite of all the noise, if a child is able to clearly hear that there is a purpose, there is a uniqueness, there is a pre-giftedness, there is a contribution unique for that time in that world in which that child is from, whichever may be the place. And believe me, every bit of your experience, whether you are born in a rich home, whether you are born in a poor home, whether you are born in India, whether you are born in America, every bit of your experience has relevance. So enabling a child to be able to see it from that perspective in itself is just a huge contribution for the right development of a child. So you don't deplete the child of that capacity. For the child then to think, unless I had this experience, then only my life will become validated and will become relevant. Unless I had an identical experience of somebody else, only then it can be, my life can be as useful. Unless I was born with the same endowment, only then my life can be useful. No, the funda is the child has a contributive role for which the child is getting prepared through a combination of all what the child experiences, even pain, even suffering, even disappointments. How a child can respond to all of these is obviously a matter that we need to put before the child's mind. You don't know, but you have obviously the faith to believe that your life was created for a purpose. And it involves contribution. It involves the other. It is not for yourself. And so when you pack that child's journey with the vision, which is so large, the child grows with capacity to sustain through all kinds of circumstances, to be able to keep again and again interpreting and reinterpreting that there is something that is getting in a way weaved into the life through all the experience. You are putting the child on solid foundation. You are doing the enabling, and you are also enabling the child to hope for its life to get actualized and be rendered splendid. The child needs to connect with something, and the child has to be enabled to become a contributor by setting that as a part of the thinking process of a child. So that is powerfully transforming, not just of an individual. Understandably, the individual is the part of the society. It is obviously creating amazing potential for transformation of society. And so this is all by and large what we have in a way practiced in our responsibilities, I believe.
Yeah.
And given you that environment.
Yeah, I think you created an environment for both of us. In a way, rich, not in terms of money, but in terms of experience, in terms of exposure. I think you even didn't protect us from things of the world. You let us see things. When I was younger, I read these Holocaust books. Like, there were stories of children who lived through the Holocaust. And even then, at that young age, it immediately struck me that not all experiences are what I am going through. And then you kind of connect with, okay, then how do I help, or how do I make this world better? So if you had protected me and said you can't read a book like that, it's too dark or too depressing, then you think this world is your world. And then you tend to think only of yourself, your family, whatever you're exposed to. So I think for both of us, me and Jethro, you created a world where you exposed us to so many different